Okie dokie, well, morning everybody, and back out again in time for some gems of war. So, this is probably gonna be another rinse and repeat, like, of the past 2 days. It's like the third day in a row I got crap sleep, just due to nothing but, nightmare-filled sleep. I think I put this down in my Twitch description. A lot of them I don't really remember. One I do remember was one of my night at work nightmares, like, just doing some stuff I probably shouldn't be doing. I think I forgot my, I think I threw my vest off somewhere and totally forgot where I threw it off, you know, that kind of thing. So, but yeah, I just kept waking up constantly. So it's gonna be another one where don't be surprised if I end up bailing early, especially on a day like today, because, there's probably not going to be a whole lot going on. Like, there's no faction assault, there's no guild wars, etc., etc. It's just going to be normal dailies and events. If I'm still awake at the time, I might do some mat farming, maybe some PvP. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. So I was kind of, my alarm went off. So I was kind of debating on whether to bother even streaming at all, because again, feeling crappy right now. And then there wouldn't be a whole lot going on the stream. I think I had the same reasoning last week. I don't think I streamed on Wednesday morning. It just felt like shit back then, and then there ain't much gonna be going on, so
yeah.
And also, like usual, when I'm on this early in the morning, it's 6:50 a.m. I'm not gonna be eating anything, so it's just gonna be water. So, and then one thing I do need to do, I forgot to do this before I started the stream up. Let me do this real fast. I gotta test my tablet. It's been cutting in and out. So we're gonna see if it. About a 5-10 second delay. So. And then musically, just gonna keep it simple. I'm not gonna play any type metal music, at least not at first. It's just gonna be some acoustic folk music. So this is another one of my morning music albums. Something I like to play when waking up. Let's go here.
Oh shit. Here we go again.
I'm trying to kill a mosquito with a sledgehammer, so let me switch to. Okay, I'm on my notepad right now. Out a little bit. See if I can find it. Mm-hmm. not. No, it's in here. That was why. Oh, I wanna. Since I joined a new guild yesterday, I'm gonna pull up the Discord. I think there was a section in the guild server that for streamers to let people know that you're on. So let me, chase this down. I might have to switch out some pages, or. Apparently not. Yeah, here we go. See how well that goes. But I'm not a real big Discord person or pretty much any kind of social media, so I'm pretty much a fish out of water as far as that goes. Thank you. For a Nexus or construct. No. Head start offers for all the. What? No idea what a head start is. I never even heard of it. But then again, I don't really read the forums much either, so. I gotta type something down here real quick. Of course, I totally forgot what I was gonna do moments after saying it. Alzheimer's. We're at level 6 already. Unless, no, wait a minute. That was, yeah, that was yesterday. Oh, I got a few seals. Discord right now. Oh, damn. I probably don't have any of these troops that these guys in my guild have, but It does kind of pique my curiosity, though. So, well, here, let me, I'm not going to need them right now. So let me at least get the basic dailies and stuff done.
Hey, well, feel my theory.
That. Okay, I gotta look at something here real quick. Thank you. Think I'm already done this one? Yeah, I'll have to keep my eye on that one. Hey, Dal. Need to get a shield up. Shield for Joe. I don't get no shield. Shield up. We're gonna have to. There, got lucky. Thank you. Sure don't get no shield. I forgot that this album, I think it's like a 45 minute, or a 40 minute album, so switch over to the next one.
There comes a chill in the air.
Oh, excuse me. Shielded.
Frightful, ghoulish, eerie sound.
not? Yeah, and in case it isn't obvious, this is a Halloween-themed album, but still pretty cool, though. It's good for year-round listening. I ain't got no shield, so much else I can do. Got no shield, so or anything else. Morning, Weird. Yeah. Apparently my subconscious don't want me sleeping or something. Maybe in my next dream. Yes! Whoops, forgot to put a shield on him. On one hand, I want to get it. Gotta put a shield on him, but gonna have to. Well, I still can. Screw. Yeah, I should have it. Oh, looks like game's gonna freeze up a moment. Okay. Okay. You use a lantern for this one, right? Like, what do you guys were saying that it was like the second boss that gives you the Imperial deeds? No, I think this is the first one. Okay. Yeah. First boss. Save it for then. Yep. Yeah, looks like we're gonna get jolted around. Looks like I'm coming quick. Thank you. Okay.
About that.
Yeah, towards the bottom. Yeah, see that? I was usually top dog on my last guild. Guess I was a big fish in a small pond. And on Discord, I posted up that I'm streaming. They have an actual section for that.
Perhaps you'd like to rest in the chamber of torment.
Yeah.
Freshly painted in Tokyo-like. Most recent tent.
Oh, okay.
Too many holes in their story. The Iron Maiden awaits.
Track.
Sir Gnomus, if you are listening this, congratulations. You want an invitation for coming to Skull Beach to participate on the Transylvanian Grand Prix. We also want you guys for playing on the ending of the festival.
All right, let's go. Okay.
Oh, okay. Map turns. Damn. Yeah. All this one.
Welcome to the Skull Beach. We're so glad you've come in time for the festival. This is great. So hear your voice. It's about to start.
Thank you.
Yep. Yeah, he's been around the block. I got a few of his, I've got the first Mr. Bungle on vinyl. Back in the day, he used to have their second album. I can't remember the name of it. It's like a eyeball. Used to play that from time to time on YouTube. Yeah, that one. I think I did yesterday or the day before.
Thank you.
God.
Yep.
it. $90 souls.
Ha ha ha!
I don't know. It just sounds funny as hell, though.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Huh? Got one. Oh, damn. 15. Yeah. Game lag a bit. All right, well, thanks for dropping by, Screw. See you next time. actually a sound effect from Age of Empires. Chance that my hero won't get silenced. It's also one of the biggest reasons why I really fucking hate this kingdom. Search.
Man,
again. Nope, fine at the moment. Let me look at Discord real quick. Nothing going on. Oh, wave temples. Okay. Thought it sounded familiar. I've already used my Zolgoth team enough. And probably shortly, I'll probably switch over to PvP. It's single player. And then, after this battle, I'll kind of show you how it works. It's PvP, yet it isn't. So with PvP, you're not actually playing a full organic human being opponent. What you are doing is you're taking on the team they have chosen as their defender. So like this team here, for example, they're defending their kingdom with this particular team here. And with PvP, it is definitely horses for courses, but that's only if you have enough teams to begin with. So there really isn't one team to rule them all. No, it's you have to use the right team to shut down the right for certain ones. Like this team here, it's basically an anti-green team. Deal double skull damage versus green enemies, You got three guys here that are gonna create two Doom Skulls every single turn. So three of them. So they're popping out six Doom Skulls every single turn. So which means I have to use my Rock Band team here. Which they're giving 5 life to all allies when you match brown gems. This entire team here are all elementals. And this is kind of important here to have. Entangling, like it shows in the upper right, it causes the top guy to deal 0 skull damage. So she gives 2 magic to the whole team whenever you match brown gems. So yeah, she kind of hit me. I don't think you played this game before. At least that's what I'm guessing. But yeah, this is like you've been seeing, it's part match 3 and it's part Magic the Gathering. So you're just like, since I have her up, Queen Ash, every card has this. Like for her, she requires 18 mana that you have to get with either blue or brown. And once you get her all filled up, then her spell will become available. So she, in this case here, she deals 46 heavy splash damage. I have to pick the enemy. I have to actually cherry pick him, and she's gonna deal that damage to him, and she's gonna deal, like it says here, 75% of that damage to the enemy above and the enemy below. And then pull them to the front. So, but yeah, one huge drawback to this game, as you've probably been watching, there's a really heavy RNG aspect to it. Like, it isn't like pinball or fighting games. A good chunk of what goes on in this game is beyond your control, and that can get pretty frustrating. Yeah, same here. Usual, you'd, in fact, let me do this real quick. I'll slow it down a little bit for you. Played that for about 9 months. If not for the fact that my computer can't handle it anymore, I'd probably still be playing it. It's also got one of the best forums I've ever seen too. Second only to the Final Fantasy XIV Lodestone. But like you're seeing here, you're just matching gems. But if you can manage to find a 4-match or a 5-match, you'll get an extra turn. And with 5 matches in this game, it doesn't have to be a straight horizontal or a straight vertical. Like you're seeing here, this is going to be a T-shape, but you can also make it in a plus shape. You can also have a 5 matches in L shapes as well. And then, depending on the color of the match you make, it gives that color a mana to anybody who might use it. And this game uses a trickle-down method. All the mana goes to the guy on the top. When he's filled up, then the next guy, the guy underneath, gets it, and so on and so forth. So here's a 4-match right here. And then, should be enough. So, now that he's up, she's gonna deal damage to an enemy, and again, due to the class he has, Elementalist, and every card is also from a kingdom. In this case here, he's from the Nexus. Same with him. He's from the Nexus, and Queen Ash. This whole team is from Nexus. So what that means is, I'm gonna get a mix of, since I have, 4 Nexus, allies, it's gonna be a mix of 24 red and brown gems.
Ass!
Didn't get a single match out of all that. Like I said, it's definitely one of the downsides to this game. Because you can get bored fucked pretty hard in this.
Hey,
Not a problem. And then, like I said a few minutes ago, PvP is all about horses for courses. This is one of the reasons why I have to use this team against the skull damage team. Because I gotta get that guy knocked to the back. Whoops. Strictly speaking, no. But, they will throw, microtransactions in your face a lot. That's another big downside of this game. Every time you get a new card, they stick a pop-up in your face. Like, to upgrade it and stuff. And then, these here, these are elemental stars. You can match them with any, with brown, blue, green, or red. And when you do, it'll destroy gems in an X pattern. You might have been seeing that. Sometimes you'll see these little X explosions. Yeah. And then, okay, so I have to keep a guy entangled at the top. Entangling is a debuff in this game that in case I didn't say it earlier. It reduces your attack power to zero, which means he'll be dealing zero skull damage. So again, with this kind of team here, they're gonna deal a shit ton of skull damage. So yeah, it's one of the beauties of this team. You can knock him to the back, or you can pull him to the front. So it's great for trying to keep an entangled troop up here at the top at all times. So, what I'm going to go ahead and do, I'm going to go ahead and take him out. Okay. This is pretty much the same exact team that I fought the last time. This is another one that's centered around doing skull damage. Although, a little bit weaker. Create two regular skulls when they're... Or, create two regular skulls every turn. And let me back up a little bit. You know, in every one of these battles here, you'll also the rewards here in the upper left corner, like, if I choose this one, I'll get 2,500 gold. I'll get, that's another little drawback of this game. There's all kinds of different types of currency, so it can get pretty confusing. Like here, you'll get 6 glory. You'll use glory to eventually open glory chests. Then you got gold chest, and you got gem, event, yep, shiny. And there's I can't. I know there's games that have it. I can't remember which ones, but this game unfortunately doesn't have it. You can't you couldn't say convert gold keys into glory, or you know you couldn't convert some of your glory keys here into gems or gem keys or anything like that. So you're basically forced to play all aspects of the game. So it's not like, say, Final Fantasy 14, or hell, even an even better example, Guild Wars 2. I mean, the game has, that game there has what's called horizontal progression. Like, there's not near the gear grind on Guild Wars 2 that there is in other MMOs. So, and in there, so because of that, you can get the best gear in the game by doing anything you want. Like, if you're a PvP person, you can get the best gear in the game just by doing PvP, and that's it. So, you know, you can get the best gear in the game just doing open world events. So, in this game here, you pretty much have to do everything. But anyway, like I was talking about, you're gonna get 6 glory from winning this battle, 3 trophies. Trophies really only matter for guild stuff. Which, since I'm on that subject, a lot of guilds that you join will have requirements. Like, in the guild that I'm in, this is one of the top guilds. I have to donate at least 1.6 million gold every week, 2,000 seals every week, and 300 trophies every week. Trophies you get just by doing various battles. Yeah, see, so I'm all good for the week. And then, yeah. And then, you get, PvP points. Which, doesn't show here. Yeah, here it is. And, PvP resets every week, I believe, Monday morning, my time. But, you have to get at least 1,900 PvP points, and then you'll get all these rewards. But only in ranked. So, 66 if you win. -4 if you lose. And that is one kind of good thing about this game. You can back out of any battle at any time. With some exceptions, like in PvP here, if I think a battle's not going my way, I could just scrub out like at any time, but it will count as a loss. And then casual, this is low risk, low reward stuff here. Off to a good start. Top guys entangled.
There we go.
bit of a quandary. He's up and ready to go, but I don't want to knock him to the back. Again, I need to keep an entangled guy up here at all times. So. Grab this five match. There we go. So yeah, you can kind of see that whenever you match those whenever you match these stars. This is going to be an interesting one. And then, as it shows there, true damage. Let me, I forgot to explain this earlier. But whenever you take damage, damage gets taken from your armor first. When you have no armor, then it gets taken from your life. True damage, however, it just gets taken straight from your life. It ignores your armor. And for this. This team here, and then I should probably explain about destroying and exploding, like exploding gems. It might show over here. Yeah, it destroys a gem and then the 8 gems around it, but you're only getting 50% mana from the gems you explode though. There's also like the last team you saw, the elemental stars, they destroy gems, which means you get full mana from all the gems you destroy. So. So, with her, I'm stealing attack from these guys, and it's getting added to my hero here. So, he's going to be dealing 157 damage. And then, this guy here. Curse is practically mandatory in PvP. It dispels all their buffs. And, it also makes any troops that have any immunities, like what it's talking about there in the upper right. Any troops that have immunities, they get removed. And then typically the way status effects work in this game, it's a cumulative 10% chance that they'll recover on their own. But if they're cursed, that becomes a 5% chance. Basically making it, for all intents and purposes, permanent. And then converting green gems to doom skulls. So yeah, you're practically gonna blow the entire board with this ability. One of the best troops in the entire game right here, Queen Beatrix. That bottom one is a big one. Because, especially in PvP, there's gonna be a shit ton of debuffs going out. So, you want to be able to cleanse all of it off of your whole entire team. She creates 9 green and 9 brown gems. Again, one of the drawbacks of this game is I have no control over where they go. They're all just thrown up there randomly. And she deals true scatter damage. Like it says over here, it's basically divided evenly. At least that's how I calculate it. And then Revenge and Rival. Whenever one of these guys attacks your kingdom, you can attack them back for Revenge, Extra Glory, Rival. I think if that's exactly what happened, like if he attacked you and you attacked him back, you guys will become rivals. I think that's how it works. Unfortunately, I tend to steer clear of any elementalist classes. To hit him before he hits me. Got off to a good start.
Holy shit.
Thank you. It's another thing this game has. Storms. Like this case here, it's a dark storm, which means purple gems are gonna fall more than other colors. Here we go. Got lucky. That could have ended badly for me. Got a leaf storm. Yeah, but there it is. Leaf, create a leaf storm. Now, green gems are gonna fall more than other colors. Frozen. Basically brown to purple. Yeah, I guess I'm hosed either way. Stealthy. Yep. So I can't target him. Hoping for a miracle, cause he's about to get that off. Thank you. tossing on them. Lucky. She's frozen. Shouldn't be getting an extra turn. PvP. Be one sudden buckle. So, tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and set the, speed back to 4x. Thank you. Surge. Pretty embarrassing if I have to bail out of a low-tier battle. Of course, I'm not exactly using my, my main team either. This team here, this is a goblin team, and one big thing they all have is their abilities all give them an extra turn, so you can theoretically do an infinite loop with this. Same with this one, so I'm not even gonna stick around for this. Just eat the loss. Lucky. maybe not. Oh, this one again. Rosen. Oh, damn. Wi-Fi is acting really wonky. Yeah, it's like going all the way up, all the way down, all the way up, all the way down. For the longest time, I had this kind of team over here, too. Okay, probably gonna be my last battle right here. And then in each of these chests, you just get random troops, you get random currency as well. Okay, so yeah, that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. Surprisingly, I lasted this long. Like I said, I didn't get shit for sleep this morning, so I was figuring I'd probably only up for an hour and then. What? No, didn't happen that way. So, but yeah, I gotta get going on my stream video. I gotta get that all prepped up and then exported to YouTube. Need to get going on my blog post as well. And there's some stuff from yesterday that I have to get typed down today, so I'm basically doing a double duty, so I gotta get going on that. And then most certainly I'll need to get a nap in there too. So, but otherwise, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And then now the way it's been going the past weeks, this is probably going to be my last stream for the week. My work week has started up Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, which means tomorrow, Friday, and Saturday. I'm usually pretty tore up from a night of work to be in much of a condition to stream, so based on that, you probably not going to be seeing me until, well, as a venture guess, probably Sunday morning. So I'll still be playing Gems of War, but I'll maybe like an hour or so, and that's about it. So, not very long. I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, well, but until then, though, everybody, take care, and I'll see you all next time.